YouTube channel. In this video, we will be talking about the core areas of mathematics. Yes, I will be giving you tips how you can good at mathematics. Some of the students are very good at mathematics and some of the students have phobia of maths. Phobia means they actually get afraid of mathematics, and some of the students actually practice a lot and they think that they are very good at mathematics, but when it comes to examination, they just forgot all of the things. Yes, now I will be discussing you with the tips that will really help you to retain the things in your mind. So my first tip is tables. Yes students, tables, preferably 1 to 25. Yes, now the question is that how my tables can help me to retain the things in maths. The first thing, you need to gain the confidence. Yes, in maths nothing is impossible. In maths also you just need a confidence only. Now in confidence, in what area? In calculation area. Yes, the two things we really need to work upon is the concepts, and next one is our calculations. See students, concept, actually clarity of concept really needed time, but your calculations, it's a long going process. Yes, to need to be work on your calculations, whether you are in 6th standard, 7th standard, 8th standard, 9th standard, 10th standard, or you are in any higher standard. Yes, these tables really help you out with whatever stream you are following, in whatever stream you are in, whatever class you are. Now first, the tables really give me confidence. Next, yes, they really help me in my calculations. And how they help me in my calculations? Suppose a child who is taking 30 seconds to solve a sum at the same child who is taking 10 seconds to solve the sum. Yes kids, we really need to become that much efficient that we will take less time to solve a sum. In that area we can say ourselves that yes, I am good at maths when I am taking less time to crack a sum. So the tables really gonna help you. Now how you can retain tables? Not only by writing 1 to 20, 1 to 25 the tables will help you. Actually the dosing will really help you. Ask somebody at your home, at your school to ask you the dosing of the tables, so that you will be very good at calculating, you will be very good at tables, and these tables will really help you out. So my next tip is, along with the tables, not the next tip, along with the tables, what you really extra need, scales. Now from scales, what I really mean is, you should know that what is 1 into 1? 1. What is 2 into 2? 2. What is 4 into 4? 16. Now the question is that why we need to learn all these things, the square. Suppose students, somebody asks you to multiply 4 times 2. If you do like that, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, it will take a time. But if you do like that in your mind only, 2 to the 4, 2 to the 4, 4, 4, I know that 4, 4, 16. It will take less time to calculate the things. And when you take less time, you gain the confidence. Yes, the whole concept of mathematics just build up on your confidence only. Confidence along with your positive attitude. When your attitude will be positive, when you are good at some of the things, and those some of the things I am discussing here. So the tables along with the squares really help you out. The next part where you really need to work upon is board mass. Yes, my second tip is board mass. Why the board mass actually helps you out? You know that board mass decides the priority of operations. Operation means your addition, your multiplication, your subtraction, your division. Now you should know that in what priority you need to solve the things when you have a long calculation. Suppose you have a calculation like this, so you should know that which operation you need to solve first. Suppose I put bracket. So B stands for bracket of division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. Now these long calculations actually help you to bind out with the mass concepts. when you able to solve this these much long calculations, you actually again gain a very much confidence in solving the sums. Suppose I have given you such a long statement and you are very good at solving with the help of board mass, and you get the answer at last. That answer will really boost up your confidence and you get a really positive approach to solve the other sums in maths. So I think the next tip really help you out if you are in higher standards. That is the conversion of units. Now, most of the students doesn't know how to convert meter into centimeter, how to convert meter into kilometer. First, they need to understand what units are used for what. When they get the answers that yes, these units are used for these things and these units are used for those things. But the next step where they actually lack is the conversion of the units. Actually, I have seen students, lot of students who are very bad at conversions. Suppose you have passed your 7th standard, 8th standard, 9th standard. Now you are in 10th standard and you are very much confident about your concepts areas. You know all the concepts, you know all the formulas, you know how to go along with the formulas. But yes, one silly mistake you can do in your sums, that is a conversion. All the things are given in meter and they ask the answers in centimeter. So you don't know how to convert it. Yes, if you know, sometimes you really had a bad experience with the conversions. So my suggestion is to keep on practicing these conversations, though you are very much confident. Yes, I know all the conversions, how to do this, how to do that. Still, do not think you are very good. Keep on practicing, because these are the core areas which will really help you this way or that way. So the next tip, which is really, really, really important, that is how to handle your operations. How to handle your operations. Now, how to handle your operations? What is the meaning of how to handle your operations? You must laugh while going with the video if I say you ki practice addition at home, practice multiplication at home, practice division, subtraction at home. But do you really think so? I have seen students who really do mistakes in these type of sums only. In addition, in multiplication, in division, in subtraction, means most of the time they did mistake in subtraction. So means if you are in 10th or 9th or 8th, in whatever class you are, if you are doing the mistakes in your addition, means you are not only doing silly mistakes, means you need to work upon the things you are lack. So means kindly do practice of these operations on not on daily basis, sometimes chalte firte. Ask somebody at your home to put the questions, to put the running questions, so that you will be getting good at these. You will be getting command in these type of things. Because the thing is that we actually know how to add the digits. We know how to subtract the digits. But sometimes we take it so, we take these things, operations so casually that we actually do mistake in these things only. इतना कैजुअली लेना भी ठीक नहीं होता, ठीक है? तो हमें लगता है कि वी आर रियली गुड एट दीज थिंग्स, बट द लेटर ऑन वी डिस्कवर दैट ओ इन पेपर मैंने यही तो मिस्टेक कर दी, मेरी एडिशन की मिस्टेक होगी, मेरी मल्टीप्लीकेशन की मिस्टेक होगी. दैट टाइम ओनली यू आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर योर मिस्टेक, नॉट योर टीचर, नॉट योर पेरेंट, नॉट योर ट्यूटर. तो दिस दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट यू नीड टू वर्क बाय योर सेल्फ ओनली, ऑन योर सेल्फ ओनली टू गेट बेटर बेस्ट. फाइन. तो last but not the least, the tip I need to discuss with you, that you need to good with the concept of LCM and HCF. Yes, everybody know how to calculate LCM, everybody know how to calculate HCF, yes, but do you actually know the usage of these two concepts in higher classes? You would be laugh at the things that they don't have much to do in higher concepts. Yes, you know that these LCM and HCF concepts are only beneficial at the lower classes only, to solve the fractions, to add the fractions, to subtract the fractions, to make the denominator same. So these concepts are for the little kids only. But no, if you really go in these concepts, you will understand that these concepts really form a large part of your algebra. Yes, if you really want to good at algebra in your mathematics, algebra means the calculation part, you need to understand that what is the usage of this. No, you are already good at how to calculate it. You actually crammed it, mugged it up, all the things you need to do while calculating the LCM and HCF. But where do you lack? You lack in only the concept. In which type of statement sums these concepts really been a helpful, really been useful to you? So again, I just want you to say that these core areas need to be worked upon on daily basis. If you really think that you don't have time to work upon on daily basis, to kindly make a timetable, kindly make these core areas in your mind that every time, every class, you need to go with these core areas. Without these top tips, without these topics, you would not excel at maths, you would not be the best in mathematics. So I hope these tips really will work you out, and kindly do comment so that I will come to know that in which kind of parts of subjects you need a video to be made by me, so that I need to understand your psychology and the problems faced by you. So do not forget to subscribe my channel if you visit for the first time, and do not click on the bell icon so that you will get the recent updates. Thank you.